ஸ்ரீ குருபியோ நமக. திஸ் இஸ் முத்து மீனாட்சி ஃப்ரம் பொன் வித்யாஸ்ரம். ஐ வெல்கம் எவ்ரி ஒன் டு த நெக்ஸ்ட் செஷன் ஆன் கிளாஸ் 8 மேத்தமேட்டிக்ஸ். திஸ் இஸ் சாப்டர் 8, கம்பேரிங் குவான்டிட்டீஸ். ஹியர் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சால்வ் த ரிமைனிங் ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் எக்ஸசைஸ் 8.2 அண்ட் திஸ் வில் பி பார்ட் 4. பிஃபோர் ஸ்டார்டிங் வித் அவர் டுடேஸ் செஷன், சில்ட்ரன், புஷ் யுவர் செல்ஃப் பிகாஸ் No one else is going to do it for you. I repeat, children, push yourself because no one else is going to do it for you. Let's start our today's session. This is question number 5 of exercise 8.2. A VCR and TV were bought for rupees 8,000 each. So the first line meaning the cost price of the VCR is 8,000. And cost price of TV is also rupees 8,000. VCR is nothing but video cassette recorder. The shopkeeper made a loss of 4% on the VCR and a profit of 8% on the TV. Find the gain or the loss percent on the whole transaction. So for VCR, the shopkeeper has made a loss, and for the TV, the shopkeeper had made a profit of 8%. Let us do it individually. That is, let us find the SP of VCR separately and TV separately. So SP is equal to CP into 1 minus loss by 100. Children, you will use this formula when loss is given. So on substituting the given data, SP is equal to 8000 into 1 minus 4 by 100. That is equal to 8000 into, on solving this, 1 minus 4 by 100, the LCM is 100. So 100 multiplied by 100, 100 minus 4, that is nothing but 96. So 8000 into 96 by 100, that is equal to rupees 7680. So this 7680 is the SP of the VCR. Now let us do it for the TV. So for TV, they have given the profit, so you have to use the formula. SP is equal to CP into 1 plus profit by 100. That is equal to 8000 into 1 plus 8 by 100. That is equal to 8000 into 108 by 100. That is equal to rupees 8640. So children, we have got the selling price of VCR as 7680 and selling price of TV is 8640. Now, let us find the total CP. Total CP is equal to rupees 7680 plus rupees 8640. That is nothing but rupees 16,320. They have given the cost price of TV is 8,000. Cost price of VCR is also 8,000. So, total CP is equal to rupees 16,000. Now, we have to find the profit. So, the profit is equal to SP minus CP. So SP is 16,320 and CP is 16,000. So on the whole, you will have a profit of rupees 320. Now we have to find the profit percentage for the whole transaction. That is nothing but profit by CP into 100. That is equal to 320 by 16,000 into 100. On solving this, you will get the result as 2%. So to conclude, he has made a profit. The profit percentage for the whole transaction is equal to 2%. I hope you understood this problem. After the video, watching the video, please work it out and see. So you will be very clear. Let's move on to the next problem. That is question number 6 of exercise 8.2. First, let me read the question. During a sale, a shop offered a discount of 10% on the marked prices of all the items. What would a customer have to pay for a pair of jeans marked at rupees 1450 and two shirts marked at rupees 850 each? Now let us discuss the solution. Marked price, that is MP of jeans, is equal to rupees 1450. Marked price of two shirts, that is equal to 850 into 2, that is equal to rupees 17,000. Now I have to find out the total marked price. That is nothing but 1450 plus 1700, that is equal to 3150 rupees, and they have also added in the question the discount is 10%. In part 1 we have discussed what is discount. So for finding the SP, you can use the formula when MP and discount are given. SP is equal to MP into 1 minus discount by 100. That is equal to 3150 into 1 minus 10 by 100. On solving this, 3150 into 90 by 100, that is nothing but rupees 2835. Therefore, to conclude, the customer will have to pay rupees 2835. So be very clear, children. SP is equal to MP into 1 minus discount by 100. This completes this problem. Now let's move on to problem number 7. A milkman sold 2 of his buffaloes for rupees 20,000 each. On one, he made a gain of 5% and on the other, a loss of 10%. Find his overall gain or loss. Moreover, in the question, they have given a hint for you. Find CP of each. Let's start with the solution, children. So we have already discussed the formulas when profit and loss are given. So SP is equal to CP into 1 plus gain by 100. So SP is 20,000. So 20,000 is equal to CP into 1 plus 5 by 100. So 20,000 is equal to CP into, that is 100 plus 5, 105 by 100. So on solving this, CP will be equal to 20,000 into 100 by 105. That is nothing but rupees 4 lakh by 21. That is, they have given, first we have calculated for profit percentage, right? Because the person has made profit on one and loss on the other. So by using the profit, that is a profit of 5%, for that we have calculated. Now let us move on for the loss percentage. The SP of the other buffalo is also 20,000. Now the loss is 10%. When loss is given, you will use the formula. SP is equal to CP into 1 minus loss by 100. So 20,000 is equal to CP into 1 minus 10 by 100. 20,000 is equal to CP into 90 by 100. On solving this, CP is equal to 20,000 into 100 by 90. All these are transposed to the other side. That will be equal to rupees 2 lakh by 9. Now let us find out the total CP of two buffaloes. So for the first one, we have taken the value as 4 lakh by 21. For the second one, it is 2 lakh by 9. We need the total CP. So for that, what we are supposed to do? We have to add both the values. Now for the LCM of 21 and 9, it is 63. So that is nothing but 12 lakh plus 14 lakh by 63. That is equal to 26 lakh by 63. Now let us find the total SP. SP of one buffalo is 20,000. So SP of two buffaloes will be 20,000 into 2. That is nothing but 40,000. Children, here it is very clear, this value, that is 26 lakh by 63, is definitely greater than 40,000. So definitely there is a loss here, there is not a profit here. So loss, for loss also we know the formula, that is nothing but CP minus SP. So rupees 26 lakh by 63 minus 40,000. In the next step, it will be, again we have to take the LCM. So on solving in the next step, you will get the result as rupees 80,000 by 63. If you divide, approximate value will be 1269.84. So to conclude, he has made a loss of rupees 1269.84. The problem looks like lengthy, but if you start solving it after your understanding, it will be easier. So kindly practice, children. Now let's move on to problem number 8. The price of TV is rupees 13,000. The sales tax charged on it is at the rate of 12%. Find the amount that Vinod will have to pay if he buys it. Let's discuss the solution. The marked price of the TV is equal to rupees 13,000. The sales tax is 12%. So selling price is equal to marked price into 1 plus ST by 100. ST is sales tax. On substituting the given data in the next step, you will get the result as 13,000 into 1 plus 12 by 100. That is nothing but 13,000 into 112 by 100. On solving this, you will get the result as rupees 14,560. To conclude, the required amount that Vinod has to pay is equal to rupees 14,560. I have only discussed 4 problems in this session. There are remaining 2 more problems and we have to start with the next exercise 8.3. 8.3 is again compound interest. So before going to the next session, children, please take your textbook or go through the video and be familiar with the formulas for compound interest. Whether it is calculated half yearly, annually, quarterly, whatever it is, please go through the formulas. To conclude, you have to be odd to be number one. I repeat, children, you have to be odd to be number one. Thank you. Thank you for the session.